you have to catch me when I'm sitting down where I can really tell you the story.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Well, briefly.
I was out here, man, when that was one rock road right there.
27th Ave, man.
27th Avenue, one rock road. One rock road, all these prepared matters. We used to live right down there. There's right behind the 4000 building, but on the other side of the street there, behind, on the church right there, mm-hmm. That's where I lived when I was a baby.
Oh.
That's where when I was a baby. And all of this was woods, prepared matter. None of this was built. Then they start building the little flat tops. This guy started building little flat tops, but even it was for farmers. But then he got to the point where he decided to go ahead on and sell them to them. But what was cheap then, but it really wasn't cheap for a black man. So it still separated the culture and
yeah.
People between those who were farming and those who were housekeepers and all that stuff like that. So, you know, we saw a change
a lot of black businesses right here in Collier City.
All the businesses.
But what's happened to the city?
Well, somebody dropped the ball.
Mm.
Our foreparents, our forefathers and all them guys, they really dropped the ball. They dropped the ball and allowed the Arabs to come in. But see, this is a part of what Donald Trump is saying, how other cultures coming in, taking up the jobs and all that stuff. But well, we are the first ones that experienced that, whether you notice or not. But we're so hush-hush until, you know, we're preaching from the pulpit something that I don't know. And I'm just on all the preachers because it shouldn't have happened. They should have been aware of it. They say to hear from God, but somebody's moving into your territory and you don't hear. Hey, every business out here was a black business.
Every business was black?
Every business was a black business, man. The Arabs done came in and took up everything. So now we're just gonna this little area right here, man, is all that's left for us. So that we're just gonna take up this little area. We don't have buildings, but we can build our own building. We can build our building on wheel and truck it out here if we have to. That's what I do.
Yeah.
Truck the building out here. It's a building. And so until such time as we get enough nerve and our preachers get enough to get the audacity to give truth about our ethnicity and our heritage and come up out of that behind that pulpit and get out and march these places down, these strongholds that Satan got, when we march and get them out of our community, then we'll have a community. Right now, we don't have a community. We don't pay taxes like we should. We don't have no business paying taxes.
Oh, man.
So we really don't have a voice. We can go down there and cry if we want to and yell and scream, but they don't hear us because money talks.
Yeah. Explain that CRE situation one more time for me about you being on your city property.
Well. Actually, the CRE owns it away from the city, from what I'm told. And he did